Welcome to the Tennis Warehouse Racket Review of the Prince Original Graphite 107. The original single green stripe POG is back. This re-released original features a bumperless design and OG grommet system. Beefed back up to a heavier spec, this version of the POG packs massive plow-through power. The oversized head and thin beam provide an extremely generous spin window to help tame the power and get shots dipping inside the lines. Let's check in with our playtesters to see how this old-school power player's racket fared on the T-Dub court.
First time picking up this racket, I could just tell right away the mass of this frame. You could tell it has a ton of plow through built into it. I felt like when I was hitting from the baseline, this racket just plows through the ball like a Mack truck. I would say a downside with that is this racket's probably far from what we consider a whippy racket or something that's easy to swing on the run. But I felt like when I had the time to step into the court, drive through the ball, I could hit a really heavy penetrating type of ball from the baseline. On serve, I like this one more on the flat serves where I could really sort of just pancake the ball and really just let the racket do the work. I felt like on kick serves and spin serves, even though it's a big head size and an open pattern, once again, it just wasn't very whippy. So it was hard for me to get that racket head speed that I would typically get with my own racket and get that ball jumping off the court. But besides that, I thought the feel of the frame was amazing. Just this thin beam, sort of pure graphite type of frame. You only get this type of feel with certain rackets going back to like some classic pro staffs, maybe even like in the modern racket, like a Phantom 93, but just a really pure feeling racket, felt connected to the ball. If I had to knock it, I would just say maybe the lack of maneuverability over a long period of hitting session. And then also one small thing that I noticed was just the kind of shorter grip for a two-handed backhand. I'd probably wrap my overgrip a little bit higher, but other than that, just a beautiful looking frame and it played well on the court.
A lot to say about this re-release of this Prince Graphite Classic 107. This is ironically the frame I spent probably most of the time playing baseline tennis when I was a kid growing up, and this really brought me back to that feeling that I had literally forgot. We're testing out some other frames with the bridge across here, and I'm just amazed at what a combination of feel I get from its thin beam and stability, keeping it from twisting at contact of the ball with that bridge across the throat. Just a great combination. The handle is a little short, so yeah, you're gonna wrap that grip up a little higher if you're, got the two-handed approach to the backhand. But overall, I mean, where do you want your power from? You're getting it from the hoop, you're getting it from the weight, you're getting it from just about every source you can. So again, it's not very much like a scalpel. It's more like Troy alluded to, like a Mack truck, just gonna plow through whatever's in its way. Not a whippy racket. I did have a little bit of issue kind of pointing the racket, getting the tip through, and hitting towards smaller targets. But spin was easily accessed, and even with a widely spaced 16-18 pattern, I was able to keep my slice really low. So shots from any part of the court were great. Over a longer period of time, racket head speed did suffer a little bit, but just a great racket overall.
As the others mentioned, this was a really fun and demanding racket to hit with. It is beefy. That was my favorite word to use as the playtest went on. I love a heavy swing weight. I enjoyed blasting balls from the baseline. It felt massive. The sweet spot was huge, and I felt like all I could do was just plow my opponents back from the baseline. As I was mentioning to the other playtesters, it really felt lethal anytime I had a swinging volley, and it was super fun to hit swinging volleys with. So at the net, it was also a dangerous weapon in my hand. I thought on serves it could be a little more demanding on those first flat serves because it is a little hefty and beefy up there as well, but really good access to spin, and I felt like second serves were awesome. So all in all, this is an amazing playtest, really fun and nostalgic.
Super fun for me to get out on the court with this racket. I tested it primarily right-handed, but due to a recent injury to my right thumb, I'm serving lefty and playing two-handed off both sides today, but this one packs a lot of plow through power, as I said in the intro of the review, and it is beefier than the other POG that we have in stock. And so this one without the bumper guard and with the old school grommets and single stripe swings a lot heavier, plays a lot heavier, and you get just big, big plow through power. I loved it at net because it was super solid on serve. I found I could use that mass to get the racket through the ball and really generate some good pace off it. On my right-handed, one-handed backhand, had to prepare a little earlier on that side just because it's a lot of racket to get moving with the weight and the oversized head. But apart from that, I really enjoyed this racket. Maybe a little bit more compact off my back swings off both sides on this one, but it is a fun racket, great collectible, beautiful racket, and beautiful out there on the court as well. For the review today, we strung this racket up with Prince's Tour XP at £59. For more information on this racket or anything else tennis related, be sure to head to Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.